I'm gonna make a change for once in my life. It's gonna feel real good. Gonna make a difference. Gonna make it right. As I turn up the collar on my favorite winter coat, this wind is blowing my mind. I see the kids in the street with not enough to eat. Who am I to be blind, pretending not to see them?
How y'all doing this evening? My name is James Hickman. We down here in Atlanta, Georgia, downtown in front of the courthouse. This is the courthouse right here. This is a multi-billion dollar business right here, down here downtown Atlanta. And right across the street, any given day, you see 50 to 100 people laying outside, but they can't help us. They can't help us at all, because they ain't trying to help us and all that. So I'm going to bring it, and I got a couple of interviews that we can talk about what's going on right here downtown Atlanta, in front of multi-billion dollar business. Because every time somebody step in that door, they're giving up money. So, hey, we need some of that money down here right now. So we need some of that money to help people out right here.
Because they got nowhere to go. That's why no one got to know.
I'm here in Atlanta, Georgia. I'm homeless, and I stay right here across the street from the court building. And I sleep right, if you can see, I sleep right back here on this wall back here. I've been homeless over a year now. I work several jobs, and I lost my job due to the income, the economy that went bad. I went to all the organizations that they had that's supposed to help people in my situation of homelessness, and came out on nothing. They didn't do anything for me. All the resources they say they had, they didn't have. So I just been stuck out here in the streets trying to figure out how I'm gonna get myself off the street, because all the other stuff, the money they say they have for us to put us in homes and stuff like that, you go to their organization, Gateway, all the other different organizations, they claim that they broke. But you know, the state get money for the homeless people, so where is the money going to? It's like they want your social security number to keep you in the rut, but they really don't want to do anything to help you. Because if they do, that means they out of a job. So I'm putting this out there to Christine Reed and the people over there at this court building and all these other government people. What is we putting y'all in the office for? What is we paying taxes for working all the year? Then when something happened, we got all this money we done paid y'all, but y'all have not done anything. I shouldn't even be out here. I've been working there since I was 14, and I've been on the street a whole year, sleeping on the wall, trying to get off these streets. All this stuff you say you have, going to class and going out and went to job fairs and everything. Don't have nothing. You don't have clothes to go to look for a proper job and stuff. Then when you go up there trying to take a shower, the women at Gateway, they get big head and tell you, oh, we don't feel like being bothered with you today. So that means you gotta go find somewhere else that you can wash up, take a shower, use the bathroom. And I really don't understand. I'm begging you, please do what we put y'all in office to do and help us get off the street. Everybody out here is not on drugs. They do not steal. They come from good family, had good jobs. The economy just made them lose everything. And now we out on the street. So I figure it's up to y'all to help us to get off the street. So do your job. Do something for us. Thank you. We don't want to be out here. Right. Y'all treat us, y'all walk past us every day like we is a non-factor of this earth.
And we're tired
like
of
we
being.
Don't matter about nothing. Y'all get the money every month for the homeless, but we don't see none of it. You got all these abandoned buildings around here. that you tear down, which you can turn into places where the homeless can get off the street and get back to where they came from. Get back on their feet, get back jobs and stuff. How can you get a job when you don't have an address to put on the application? How can you get a job when you don't have no phone? How can you get a job when you can't, you go to these places where you can take a bath and stuff, and they tell you, no, you can't take a bath today? How can you find a job? You can't find a job. You don't have clean clothes. You don't have money to wash clothes. You know, I shouldn't be sleeping on this wall. I'm right here across the street from the court building and next to the Capitol. I shouldn't have to sleep on this wall when I pay taxes every year. Every year.
And that ain't even that handful. You speak to some of these folks out here, they frying their face up like you got a disease. So you be like, excuse me, I'm just only trying to speak. Yeah. Like, really? All that is not really called for. Y'all say
take
y'all
your hands out the
y'all
cookie
say,
jar.
They say
take your hands out the cookie jar and start doing your job. They need to get you out of office.
Don't walk in front of the camera, baby.
They saying that they're doing what they supposed to be doing, but whether they really stealing all the money and pocketing all that money and they not doing their job. Why won't they fix these potholes in these streets?
We don't got no car. We sleeping on the wall.
Yeah, for real.
Hi, I'm Joan. I've been at homeless for 4.5 years. No one has ever done anything for me the whole time I've been homeless. Now, no food, no place to bathe. Now, what you need to do is get off your fat cats and take and help the homeless people. You got enough money to help us. You got enough to take these buildings that you got abandoned, fix them up, and give us somewhere to live. All of us are out here do not do drugs. I do not do drugs. And I don't like being labeled as a crackhead. I have glaucoma, so I can't work. When I lost my job, I became homeless. The only thing that I learned that they do here is they take you shelter to shelter, but they will not put a roof over your head. All of us cannot live with other people. I'm one of them. And I would like for them to do something for us as soon as possible. Thank you.
This is to Nathan Deals and Christine Reed and the people, the government over Georgia. Y'all get money every year for us. What's going on with the middle? Stop giving yourself raises for $50,000, $150,000 and stuff. Y'all walk past us every day and see us sleeping on this wall. Y'all don't do anything. Y'all know these folks down here taking money from the homeless. What about us? Y'all treat us like we don't matter. We are human beings too. We still vote for half of y'all to get in the office. Y'all need to treat us concordantly. Y'all need to help us. Y'all need to stand up and take. Y'all keep talking about Georgia. Georgia ain't shit. You haven't done, I've been here since 92. Georgia had declined since 92. It was a nice state when I came here, but I wish like hell now that I have not came to Georgia. I'd rather go to a third world country than be here in Georgia. Y'all got all of this money, so much money. Y'all can't take these abandoned buildings or nothing and fix it up for us. Give us a start. You got people that been working for years out here, and y'all, when this economy hit, we gonna help y'all. We gonna get y'all back to y'all. But what help have y'all done? Y'all haven't done. You got women and children out here. You got old folks out here with old timers and stuff. Y'all have not. Y'all walk past it every day. We right here by the Capitol, and y'all have not done anything. What is the problem? What is the problem? Then when the homeless folks go to stealing and robbing and stuff, then they rob, but how else can they survive? We come to y'all, we go through every program y'all set out for. Y'all have not done anything. Y'all haven't done nothing for the mentally health. You got people out here that's mentally health. They got schizophrenia, bipolar, that's major depression. And y'all let these people stay out here and don't do anything. Yep, y'all steal the money. You steal the food, you steal the clothes that people donate for us to go out there and get jobs and stuff. Why? Why help us? We are begging y'all to help us. We don't like being on this street no more than y'all like us being on this street. Y'all need to help us. Don't keep saying, oh, we put the program to help y'all. The program is set up for y'all. And for y'all can say y'all did something. Y'all is stealing the money. Stop stealing the money. Stop stealing the money. Stop stealing the money and give it to the people according to who needs it.
They need to
y'all say y'all have money for apartments and houses for us. Where is it? Because I done went to every agency with all the documents. I haven't got a house. I haven't got a apartment. I haven't even got a room from y'all. So what's going on? Somebody tell me something. I'm a taxpayer. I'm a voter. Explain to me why you not helping me. Tell me something. I want to know something. Do I have to go to the White House and protest? Tell me something. I don't understand. Or if this is just a racist state, you only take care of the white and say fuck the black. What is it? Tell me something. I don't understand. I don't understand it. For real, I don't understand. And I get mad. And I be want to go up there and kick in some doors and tell you, look, this is why I'm sleeping on this cardboard. Cardboard in the middle of the winter now. Cardboard and blanket. You got to go use the bathroom outside because people don't want you in their bathroom because they know you sleeping outside. Where is the money? I'm tired of being out here. I am tired. I am 50 years old. I am tired. I done paid my dues. And I would like to get off these streets. Help me. Help me. Thank you.
We're homeless. We need help. And we try to get help. We try to get help from everywhere else. But they give me one paper to go to another place to refer me to get some more paper. I got two. And then, yeah, they want to help. They say that we need to make three times our rent to go ahead and get some help from the HPRP program, but then they're supposed to be able to help us. How is that if we only get $674? We're going to be here on this wall. There's low-income housing that's not even ready to 2012 of December. We on the wall with blankets, it's cold, and cardboard. Look, we got to block the wind with cardboard. This is my baby. Little Jazzy, say hi.
Hi.
We are on this road. There's not enough shelters for us to stay. They want us to go to day center and way down up when they don't have anybody come and help us. The people out here help us more than the people that's supposed to help us. What happened to America? We're the ones supposed to get help. Y'all get the money and we can't even. We're living on the wall in front of a church, in front of a capitol. Something wrong with y'all. All I need is $350. I can't even get that. But yeah, you guys want to refer us to one church, to another church, and then to another agency. All these agencies, all I keep getting, paper and paper, to get help. Oh, they'll help you. Salvation Army will help you. This person will help. Nobody can help us but you. You guys don't like to see us on the wall with a baby, but then you guys won't do nothing. You guys complain to us that we're here on the wall, but you guys won't help us. Referrals won't help us, money will. And you guys got it.
It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will.